3rd of October, we were in a place called Mogadishu, Somalia. I was the commander of the Delta Force. You've seen this in the movie Black Hawk Down. As we fought our way through the streets of Mogadishu, trying to get to a Black Hawk that had been shot down in the streets, where we knew there were still men alive, we fought our way to that crash. Only 30 minutes later, a second Black Hawk was hit by a rocket-propelled grenade right in the rudder blades, and he went in 1,800 meters away. And there was a Black Hawk flying over the crash site there with two young men in it named Randy Shugart and Gary Gordon. They were Delta snipers. They had their sniper rifles up in the aircraft and they'd been engaging targets. And they called on the radio. And they said, "Sir, those men are still alive in that second crash. We see them moving. They're not getting out, but they're still alive. Put us in. We'll get them out of the crash." And I had to say to them, "Guys, everybody's gone to the first crash. I'm trying to assemble a force right now that can go to that crash, but if I put you in, I can't support you. You'll be on your own. I can't support you." I said, "Stay above them. Use your sniper rifles and just take out anybody you can. Fire on anybody that tries to get near that crash. Keep them off as long as you can." "Roger," they said. They called back in a few minutes and they said, "Sir, we're doing the best we can, but there's too many of them. They just keep coming to the crash. There's too many of them. They're going to get overrun. Put us in." Had to say a second time, "No, we're almost assembled. We grabbed the cooks and the clerks and the mechanics and everybody. We've got them all loaded up. We'll get to you as quickly as we can, but we can't support you." I said, "Keep firing. Use the door guns on the helicopter if you have to. Knock them down, but don't let them get near that crash." Finally called back and he said, "Sir, we've done everything we can. We can't keep them off." And they said, "Sir, we're the only hope. Put us in. We're the only hope. Put us in." I said, "Do you understand what you're asking for?" "Yes, we understand. We're the only hope. Put us in." Said, "Okay, put them in." They came in low. They got over a small open site about 50 meters from the crash. And they literally jumped out of the helicopter with their sniper rifles. Kicked down a small wall and they fought their way into the crash. They very carefully unbuckled each seat belt, carefully lifted their buddies out of the crash, laid them out. And then they moved around on the other side of the helicopter and they began to engage the Somalis, the wild-eyed, drug-crazed Somalis that were trying to overrun the crash, yelling and screaming. They began to engage them, taking them out as they come across the wall. And finally, Gary Gordon, one of the two, the senior of the two, ran back to the pilot, a guy named Mike Durant, who has written a wonderful book called In the Company of Heroes. And he said, "Is there any more ammunition? We're running out." And Durant said, "There's ammunition right behind the pilot's seat." He ran into the crash. He grabbed all the ammunition that was left. He went back and took a small Hecker Coke MP5 submachine gun, laid it on Mike Durant's chest and said, "Good luck." He ran back and tossed ammunition to Randy Shugart. And then they started shooting again. And pretty soon, as Mike Durant relays the story, He heard Randy Shugart yell out, "Gary, I'm hit." And then his gun went silent and Randy Shugart was dead. And then Mike Durant heard Gary Gordon yell, "Mike, I'm hit bad." And then his gun went silent and he was dead. And pretty soon the Somalis overran the site, and the only survivor was Mike Durant. He lived to tell the story. I stood in the Oval Office as President Bill Clinton presented the medals of honor to the widows and the families of Gary Gordon and Randy Shugart. The bravery above and beyond the call of duty. Those young men died for what they believed. They died for 4 men on the ground. You know something? There are Christians dying all over this nation. I mean, all over this world today. There are Christians being martyred for their faith. A lot of people didn't take this young lady out of Ohio, Rivka Berry, seriously. But there are honor killings in this country for converting to Islam. There are Christians all over the world that are dying for their faith. And the question is, how many people in this country are willing to even stand up and take criticism for their faith? Where are the men? What price are you willing to pay for your faith? What price are you willing to pay for this nation? Are you willing to stand when everybody else bows? It doesn't matter how old you are. We've got a precious young man sitting right here. Your faith is going to be tested, son. Your faith is going to be tested, but if you stand just like those men did, you're going to be blessed. God's going to use you. He's going to use you to save this country. He's going to use you to turn this country around. To save this world. Put us in. We're the only hope. Men, you're the only hope for this country. You and men like you that are filled with the Spirit of God, that are willing to stand in these tough times.